I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. We're going to be making an appetizer that is cream cheese with Jezebel sauce. And if you've never had or heard of Jezebel sauce, when you hear this recipe, you will think that this isn't going to work. But I can tell you that it forms a lovely sauce, and I think you'll really like it. It will be very tasty, and it makes a large quantity. Which you can vary, of course, but if you make quite a bit, you can save it in the refrigerator for some time. What we need is a medium to large mixing bowl, and into that we're going to put either apricot or pineapple preserves. Doesn't matter. I happen to have this at home already, and this is sugar-free. It's sweetened with Splenda, and the size of this is 12.75 ounces. What I want is to use 10 ounces of this preserve, and also I have some jelly. I'll be using 10 ounces of. That means, when I dip this out, I'm going to leave maybe an inch or so in the bottom. So let me see if I can dig in here and get out apricot preserves in the amount of approximately 10 ounces. There are standard size jars that are 10 ounces. I just, as I said, had this already at home, and it's 12.75, so I certainly had enough, and I'll just stick the rest in the refrigerator to use on English muffin or something. So we have that. The next item is apple jelly. Now this, I think, is 18 ounces, but we want only 10 ounces, so I'll need a little more than half. So I'm going to get another spoon out and dig into this, and just know that I'm going down a little past the halfway point. You don't have to be exact on these measurements. Obviously, I'm just guessing at what I think is half, something like that, maybe a little bit more there. And that takes care of that. The next thing we have coming up is a 5 ounce jar of horseradish. Now it will say prepared horseradish, but you'll probably find it in your deli section rather than where the mustards and prepared horseradishes might be, because it's mainly just horseradish with very few additives. So it takes the whole jar. I'm going to put all of that in. So what you're seeing is something that is very strong flavored, the horseradish being mixed with a couple of items that are very sweet. Strange combination, but believe me, it will work if you can get all that out, which looks like I'm not going to get quite all of it, but close enough. It should be the kind of horseradish that looks chopped like this. If it looks like mayonnaise, then it is called prepared horseradish, but it's meant for spreading like on a roast beef sandwich. It's not exactly what we want. This is what we want. The next item I have is ground mustard, and you're probably thinking, oh, she'll add about 1 teaspoon or so. It's the whole can. 1.37 ounce can, or if yours doesn't come in that size, if it's 2 ounces or something, it's not gonna make much difference. Just put it in. I know you think I'm making this up, but there are many versions of Jezebel sauce floating around out there, and this just happens to be my version. Some of them have more ingredients, some have less, some use different flavors, but they're all based on this idea of sweet and then that very strong, pungent horseradish that goes with it. And to top this off, we have 1 tablespoon of black pepper. So it's just your normal ground black pepper, and 1 tablespoon of it. One good thing about this is not only does it taste very intriguing and interesting and good, but it's extremely easy to make. The hardest thing I had to do was to get that amount of jelly out because I didn't have the right size of jars. But if you can find exactly the 10-ounce jars, then you won't have to be guessing or doing anything like that. This is easy to blend together. You don't need a mixer or anything. Just use your spoon or a fork and keep going around so that you hit all of those lumpy areas and get it all smoothed out. And then you're getting ready to serve it. That's what it should look like. Now in serving it, I am using I'm just doing a small amount today, so this is only a 3-ounce piece of cream cheese. I am using the fat-free cream cheese. This is an 8-ounce package, but I just cut off the 3 ounces because I knew I didn't really have a use for more than that. Ladle this over the top and just let it run down the edges. By the way, the cream cheese is at room temperature, and that's what it's going to look like. Let me scoop that up a little bit so it looks a little better. And then serve it with some nice crackers. I've just chosen reduced fat Ritz crackers. You can use regular Ritz crackers, you can use Townhouse cracker, you could use flavored crackers, but since there's so much flavor here, I think I would use something very plain. You could use a wheat cracker, whatever you like, but I'm going to show you that this is a very nice flavor. I'm going to take plenty of it, so if I choke here, you'll know that it didn't work, but it is good. It leaves a taste to remember. You'll like it. Well, I'm back, and my husband and I have been just gobbling this up since I went away. I meant to tell you, and I did allude to the fact that you can keep this. What I would do is, if you have like a mayonnaise jar that you've used up the mayonnaise, which I always put in the dishwasher and keep for if I have grease that I want to get rid of, then I pour it in there and so on. But this is something I want to say. I certainly can't use all of this tonight, but this keeps a month in the refrigerator. So all you need to do is just take your mayonnaise jar, and I probably should have gotten a funnel or something and poured this in, but basically make the transfer from one to the other. I'm not going to go all the way up to the top, but just imagine you get that full, you put on the lid, it goes in the refrigerator. Anytime you want to have this dip, get out your cream cheese, get it to room temperature. If you need to, microwave it for 10 seconds. Got your sauce ready, and it will be even better. It'll be tastier than it is right now because it will be blended in terms of the flavors. I hope you try this because it sounds like it just won't work, but and I thought that the first time I ever tried it. But it is a taste that you just won't believe if you don't try it. You can Google Jezebel sauce and get an idea of what different people put in theirs. But this is my version, and I just wanted to show it to you. See you later.